During a road safety awareness campaign organized by Safeway Rightway in Bulisa Town Council, Lawrence Sendegaya, the officer in charge of traffic in Bulisa District, explained that over 500 fatal accidents were recorded from the 9 districts of the Alberton region that include Hoima City, Hoima District, Bulisa, Chiliandongo, Masindi, Chikube, Chibale, Kagadi and Kakumiro. He has attributed the accidents to overspeeding by the drivers and cyclists, the failure to respect road signs and herdsmen grazing animals on the roadside.
Now for you come from Kampala, you'll find someone excited to look at a vehicle with big tires. Now for you, why is this man standing in the road? Yes, he's standing in the road because he's trying to admire the vehicle. But that doesn't give you the right to know that person.
Peter Tibigamba, the Chief Executive Officer, Safeway Rightway, revealed that Bulisa, which hosts the Tilenga project, recorded a reduced number of fatal accidents, while Hoima City had an increase of 44%, followed by Chikube District.
I think Moya was just around 32% reduction as well, and then Chikube was around 6% reduction. Unfortunately, when we look at Hoima, we recorded about 44% increase.
Workers at Total Energies blamed accidents on domestic animals that loiter around roads, while other locals target compensation if there is any accident.
With us on Chilenga, these animals, you know, these are Total vehicles. But when they hear a taxi coming, chief, they sort themselves.
If we keep this up, by the end of 2024, our accident or our fatality numbers will go down from 1 to 0. The other issue that we had at that time was what? Like he mentioned, people knew that if you knock my car, my goat, we're going to compensate you highly. The gentleman has put it out there. He said if we run into something, police gets involved. And when police gets involved, well, you stand a risk of getting nothing, but you also stand a high possibility of going to prison for this one.
James Katunguka, a senior road safety officer at the Ministry of Works and Transport, urged locals in Bulisa District to graze their domestic cattle in fenced paddocks. He also asked UNRWA to gazette areas for cattle crossing while heading to Lake Albert to drink water.
The only way how we can control these animals is to keep them in fences.
Gilbert Tabasima, the vice chairperson of Bulisa District, faulted UNRWA for not considering roundabouts in risky areas, particularly junctions.
And put a roundabout instead of leaving corners at an option of a person using the road. I think that will serve better because the traffic is increasing time and again.
Irene Musinguzi, the road safety consultant, observes that there are many black spots for accidents along Hoima Bisobulisa Wanseko Road. She recommends that UNRWA should think about increasing road signage.
Of course, the road design, some of the issues with road design, the fact that road design actually hindered their safety, and then, of course, the lack of speed humps.
However, Winfred Anyaita, who represented UNRWA station engineer, decried rampant vandalism of signage.
It's the same road signage, so it's something that is ongoing. Today they remove, replace. They remove, replace. It's something that is ongoing as it goes to the district. Maybe leaders, they need to keep sensitizing the communities about the importance of these road signs.
Meanwhile, Arnold Bwambale from Kosulu that operates oil rigs advised police to always provide a detailed report after a fatal accident rather than providing preliminary investigation reports.
In January last month, between 21st and 27th, we had over 290 crashes, but all we got were preliminary reports. And I would send this request to the police that are here with us to kindly avail this information.
Story compiled by Ambrose Niwagaba Katoto for the news.